Hi, welcome to part 3 of motion. In the first part, we discussed what is the difference between distance and displacement. In the second part, we discussed what is the difference between speed and velocity. We also have learned equations for calculating speed and velocity. Just recalling that equations, which are the equations we have learned? Speed equal to distance divided by time. Okay, so if it is average speed, you have to take total distance divided by total time, and velocity is displacement divided by time. Okay, displacement divided by time. If it is average velocity, you are supposed to take initial velocity, which is u, plus final velocity v divided by 2. So these are the equations we discussed in the last class. So today's session, I am going to explain some of the numericals given in your textbook, along with we have to learn a new concept, which is scalars and vectors. Okay, so first let's go to the numericals. I'm going to do the example 8.2 in your textbook, page number 102. Look at this question. The odometer of a car reads 2000 km at the start of a trip. So when he started the trip, the odometer reading was 2000 km. What is this odometer? Odometer is an instrument for measuring distance. Speedometer is an instrument for measuring speed. At the start of the trip and 2400 km at the end of the trip. Okay, so he at the end of the trip, it is 2400 km. At the end, if the trip takes 8 hours, okay, so he is taking 8 hours for the journey. Calculate the average speed of the car in kilometer per hour and meter per second. Okay, so in this particular question, actually he is not starting, when he started the journey, his distance was 2000 kilometer. So what is the distance covered by him in the time interval of 8 hours? So in 8 hours, he is not covering, he is covering 400 kilometer. Why? Because he started from 2000, he ended in 2400. So what is the distance? Speed equals distance. How much distance he covered? He covered 400 kilometer divided by 8. 400 kilometer by 8 will be how much? It will be 50 kilometer per hour. Okay, so this is your answer, 50 kilometer per hour. You have to express your answer in meter per second also. So how to convert kilometer per hour to meter per second? To convert kilometer per hour to meter per second, multiply by 5 by 18. Okay, this is the easy way. In order to, instead of converting kilometer to meter, hour to second, or something like that, just multiply it by 5 by 18. How you will get 5 by 18? Because kilometer is 1000 meter and 1 hour is 3600 seconds. So when you cancel, you will get 5 by 18. Okay, so instead of multiplying all these things, multiply by 5 by 18. So 50 into 5 by 18. How much it will come? Let's see the answer. What is in the answer given over here? When you are doing the calculation, it will come almost 13.9 meter per second. Okay, the answer is 30.9 meter per second. You can calculate it by 250 divided by 18. When you calculate 250 divided by 18, you will get 13.9 meter per second. This is how we will do the first question. Okay, and now let's look at the second example given in your textbook. This is the second example given in your textbook, 8.3. Usha swims in a 90 meter long pool. She covers 180 meter in 1 minute by swimming from one end to the other end and back along the same straight path. Find the average speed and average velocity of Usha. What is its average speed? Average speed is equal to total distance. Total S. What is S stands for? Distance divided by total time. Okay, time, t is the time. What is total distance? It is 180 meter because she is moving, she's crossing the swimming pool. Once she's moving forward, then she's come back. So together it is 180, and she is taking 1 minute, which is 60 seconds. Don't forget to convert into seconds, okay? Then it will be meter per 3 meter per second. So this is her average speed. What about the average velocity? Average velocity is equal to displacement divided by, because here we cannot use the equation initial speed plus final speed, okay? Because we have learned that equation, but we cannot calculate from the data given over there. So you cannot think that way, okay? So average velocity is equal to displacement divided by total time taken, okay? So displacement divided by total time. So in this case, she's moving forward and she's coming back to the same point. So the displacement is zero. Since the displacement is zero, average velocity is also becomes equal to zero, okay? So the same kind of journey. Look here, in this example, they are describing the same journey. How speed and velocity are different? Speed is 3 meter per second, while this velocity becomes 0. Okay, so this is how the direction, when you are adding direction to speed, the things will get changed. Okay, so this is these two are the worked out example in your textbook. Now let's have a look at the questions given in the textbook. This exercise questions, distinguish between speed and velocity. That I already told you, can write the definition of speed, definition of velocity. Speed is having only magnitude, velocity is having magnitude and direction. Speed will not be equal to zero for a moving object. For a moving object, velocity can be equal to zero. Speed is always positive, velocity can be positive and negative. So these points you can write. Look at the next question. Under what condition is the magnitude of average velocity of an object equal to its average speed? Okay, so that is the next question. Okay, I am going to do the second question. Under what conditions is the magnitude of average velocity? Average velocity. So average velocity, how we will write the equation? Average velocity is equal to displacement divided by time. Okay, so that is the equation for average velocity, displacement divided by time. What about average speed? Average speed is equal to total distance divided by total time. Total distance divided by total time. Okay, they are asking when these things will become, velocity and speed becomes equal. When distance and displacement becomes equal, or in when the object is moving in a straight line only, when the distance and displacement is equal, you can say that velocity, average velocity and average speed is equal to zero. Okay, so when distance and displacement are the same, we can say average velocity is equal to average speed. Okay, then let's see question number 3. What does the odometer of an automobile measure? I already told it measure distance. Next, what does the path of an object look like when it is in uniform motion? When the object is in uniform motion, especially in our lesson, we are talking about straight line motion. So you can write the answer as straight line motion. Path of the object will be a straight line, because in this particular lesson, we are talking only about straight line motions. Okay. Next one. During an experiment, a signal from a spaceship reached the ground station in 5 minutes. So time taken for reaching to the ground station is 5 minutes. That is 5 into 60 is equal to 300 seconds. Okay. Next one. What was the distance of the spaceship from the ground station? The signal travels at a speed. Speed of the this one, V is also given, 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second. Okay, so in this case, you have to calculate the distance. You know the what is the equation for distance, what is the equation for calculating distance. You can rearrange the equation for calculating speed. Okay, a speed equation is distance divided by type. Okay, so this S stands for distance. So distance is equal to speed into time. So S is equal to speed is 3 into 10 raised to 8 into 300. So how much it will become? This is 9 into 10 raised to 10 meter. How I got 9 into 10 raised to 10? Look, 3 into 3, 9. These two zeros I keep over here. So it is during an experiment, a signal reaches the ground. Okay, so this is how we can. So these questions are easy questions. You just have to use the equation. Okay. So now I have to we have to learn one more topic regarding related to motion, okay, which is scalars and vectors. Okay, so let's see, these two terms are new for you. When you are speed and only grade 9 students, may mostly they have heard this term. The next one is a new term, scalars and vectors. Okay, actually this is a classification of physical quantities. Okay, we know what is physical quantity. We have learned some physical quantity. Take an example of the physical quantities we have learned: distance, displacement, then speed, velocity. Okay, let's have a look at the difference between these things. Okay, so when I am telling speed is 10 meter per second, we know that this shows only magnitude, so this is representing speed. When I am giving you a quantity, like I am giving you a number like 10 meter per second, by looking at the unit of this one, you can find out that meter per second. So if this one is something related to speed, 10 is the magnitude, so it became speed. If I add a direction to this one, this becomes velocity. Okay, so speed with direction is called velocity. Scalars are quantities which you need only magnitude for defining them. They have only magnitude, like speed, distance also the same way, 10 meter. That is complete. We cannot add more things to that one. Okay. So these kind of quantities are called scalar quantities. While vectors are quantities which have both magnitude and direction. That means 10 meter per second towards north, that makes it a vector. It has both magnitude, that means the numerical value is there, along with that one it is having the direction, so it becomes the vector. The same way displacement also, it is like that, 10 meter towards right. Okay, in that case you are specifying the magnitude, you are specifying the direction, then only that physical quantity becomes complete. Okay, so these kind of quantities are called vector quantities. There are two kind of physical quantities, scalar quantities and vector quantities. Scalar quantities are quantities which have only magnitude. Vectors are having both magnitude and directions. Okay, distance, speed are by scalar quantities, displacement and vector are vector quantities. When you are in your higher classes, when you go to another lessons and all, you will come learn more about, you will see more scalars and vectors. Okay, I will tell one more example of that one. For example, you have weight. Suppose we are telling about the weight or gravitational force acting on an object, 10 newton. Suppose this one is the gravitational force. Is it a vector quantity or a scalar quantity? Gravitational force, okay, or gravity, weight of the object. This one is, we know that gravity is always acting towards the center of Earth. So it is also, it is has a direction also. It is having magnitude, it has a direction also. So this becomes a vector quantity. But suppose you are specifying your temperature, or your temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. That is complete. There is no need of telling any direction for the temperature. So it is a scalar quantity. Okay, there are many scalar quantities and vector quantities. So scalar is having only magnitude, vector is having both magnitude and direction. Okay, so that question is also important because it's a new topic for you. So whenever you are learning a new physical quantities, try to classify, you try to find out whether it is a vector or a scalar. Okay, so this is the I am going to wind up this session. So we did some numericals and we explained what is scalar and what is vector quantity. Any doubt is there, or you want to solve any questions or any doubt in what I discussed today, please comment below this video and we will continue in the next class. Okay, thank you.